Congratulations, my name is Ajinder Singh. It is good to be back with all of you. This morning, we are going to be studying 1 Corinthians chapter 2. In this chapter, Paul explains how he relied on the Holy Spirit when sharing Jesus with others. He goes on to also explain what a privilege it is to have the Holy Spirit with us. The Holy Spirit himself gives us revelation of God's plans. And because we have the Holy Spirit, we can know the wonderful things God has freely given us. It is important that we read the entire chapter and reflect on the deep work that the Holy Spirit seeks to do in us by revealing God's own thoughts, as verse 12 puts it to us. Let's look at the key verses. Let's read. For I decided that while I was with you, I would forget everything except Jesus Christ, the one who was crucified. I came to you in weakness, timid and trembling, and my message and my preaching were very plain. Rather than using clever and persuasive speeches, I relied only on the power of the Holy Spirit. Paul makes it very clear that despite his own educational status and obvious wisdom, when he came to sharing the message of the gospel, he set aside all of this and relied primarily on the Holy Spirit to help him do so. I found Paul's words in these key verses to be very encouraging. We have the Holy Spirit himself to help us fulfill God's plan for us to share Jesus with others. What more do we need? While preparing this devotion, I was reminded of what happened when I was just 20 years of age and had just come to know Jesus myself. I felt an urging by the Holy Spirit to share Jesus with my uncle, who was a father figure to me. I resisted the urge. Not only was he much older in age, he was also an authority figure in my life. Would he react negatively and scold me if I did so? I was afraid of this. When I finally obeyed, I submitted and relied on the Holy Spirit to help me do so. I told him simply that Jesus was the only way and that Jesus had brought peace into my life. Thankfully, my uncle was receptive, and ultimately, through the efforts of my mother and aunties who were saved, he finally accepted the Lord. I am glad that he did so. Unfortunately, several years later, he passed away from cancer. But because we knew he was with Jesus, the sorrow that we felt was tempered with this joy. So let us all be encouraged today that through the power of the Holy Spirit, we can indeed share Jesus with others, including those whom we may perceive as older, maybe wiser, and maybe even more senior than us. We only have to obey the Holy Spirit's urgings and submit to his leading. Come, let's all pray to reflect on this. Father, I thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit. I thank you, Lord, that the Holy Spirit himself leads and guides us in sharing Jesus with others. I pray that you help all of us to submit to the Holy Spirit's leading in this area. And I ask that you embolden all of us to share Jesus with our loved ones and others around us. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. There are application questions for you to consider as well as you go through this devotion. I will now put them up for you. Please consider them as you go through the devotion, and thank you for joining me today. Have a good day.